Survival is the number of people still alive for a set time period after being diagnosed with cancer. Usually, people who study cancer look at the first 5 years after someone is diagnosed. It would be possible to use a different length of time because many people with cancer live well beyond 5 years after their diagnosis, but 5 years is the standard used in the medical world. Therefore, to measure survival, we follow everyone diagnosed with a certain type of cancer and see what percentage of them are still alive after 5 years. Here's an example of how we measure survival. Let's imagine we have five men, all diagnosed with cancer in the same year. We will follow these five men over the course of the next 5 years to see how many are still living at the end of that time. In this group, two men survive at least 5 years. One, unfortunately, dies 3 years after being diagnosed. One dies 4 years after being diagnosed. And one survives at least 5 years. In this group, three out of five men diagnosed with cancer survived for at least 5 years from the time they were diagnosed. So the 5-year survival for this cancer is 3 out of 5, or 60%. This graph shows 5-year cancer survival for First Nations in Ontario from 1992 to 2001. These real-life results are slightly older, but they show us how cancer survival depends a lot on cancer type. Nearly three-quarters of people diagnosed with breast and prostate cancer lived for at least 5 years afterwards. But for certain other cancers, particularly lung cancer at the other side of the graph, survival is very low. Survival gets better when more cancers are caught early, before they spread to other parts of the body. If more people get screened for breast, cervical, and colorectal cancers, we are more likely to catch them early when they have caused less damage to someone's body and are easier to treat. Survival also goes up when there are improvements in cancer treatments. When we have new technologies or medications that are better at treating cancer, people are more likely to live longer. Another big part of improving survival is making sure that people with cancer have healthy habits, which will help their treatments work better and make their cancer less likely to return in the future. We measure cancer survival because we want to know how many people die early from cancer. Tracking survival lets us measure which cancers we're getting better at treating and finding when they're easier to treat. We also can learn whether survival is worse for some cancers or populations. If people in a certain population or area are less likely to survive a certain kind of cancer, we want to know why. Are people being diagnosed later due to gaps in screening? Are people having trouble getting the health care they need? Do they have other medical conditions that are affecting their health? Another important reason to measure survival is to plan the ongoing support and follow-up care that survivors need to stay healthy after they finish their cancer treatment.